Was India ever part of Africa? India was once an African nation. Please, Rabbi Elam Dumizulu here for Amity Hebrew Ethics. My father came. India was once an African nation. Came out of the mother of all countries on earth, or so-called continents. But we want to also say, how will this kind of knowledge assist anybody who hears it? We are going to answer that shortly. But let's look at geology a little bit. Ancient geology and modern geography confirm that India was once an African country. India was part of the supercontinent called Gondwana some 140 million years ago. This Gondwana was composed of modern South America, Africa, Antarctica, and Australia. But Africa is the mother of all of them. Plate consists of India and modern Madagascar started to drift away. Then India split from Madagascar and drifted north. Here is why knowing that India was once an African country is very critical knowledge. In all so-called continents, autochthonous and indigenous people are Negroes, Pan-Africans, Melanesian Negroids, Indo-Negroids, Negro-Australoids, and Blacks, called Negritos in other books. But they are all Bantus, Vanu, Ngabantu. In other words, we are saying they are melanin dominant humans versus melanin recessive people. It's time that we must start believing that as melanin dominant humans, we are the original and indigenous and autochthonous on the earth, and that we should never lack self-knowledge, self-confidence, self-belief and ability. It is time to revive and return to black Negro religions that help develop the mind, the body, the soul, the spirit, and the belief in self, rather than in other people's shrines, churches, mosques, temples, and gods or divinities, even reading their books and believing them and preaching them and teaching them. It's time for us to know that Africa and many of these lands are holy lands, and that we are people that are never cursed, and that we must preach the oneness of melanin dominant humans. That's the importance of this knowledge. It should unite everyone in India who is melanin dominant with every other brother found anywhere on the earth. We will have our little differences, right? Correct, fair and fine. But once you discover that this person is and is melanin dominant, he's your brother, she's your sister, and we are one people. That's why it is very critical to apply this knowing that India was once our country, an African country. So geology has given us this link that Africa physically gave birth to the Indian subcontinent. However, if you start to research about the African presence in India in antiquity, you get the lies and deliberate distortions like this one peddled by a prominent news source. Unfortunately, millions imbibe this kind of poor scholarship and run along with it, not knowing that it's propaganda. Here is the title that one newspaper said, the BBC, you can find the website here. It says, an African origin ethnic tribe of about 20,000 people has been living in near total obscurity in India for centuries. This is a lie, a total lie. The title could be saying a good story about the Africans that were taken during slavery and put there, but it is obscuring a bigger, very huge picture. These 20,000 people are indigenous to India, even though they came from Africa a few years ago. The Travis Marco Polo and his description of the people that he found in India destroys that, because he found black people, and Marco Polo said he found people who were much more black, who were using sesame to become darker than before. There it is, the proof. Even Carlo Pizzat confronts the challenges of writing an Indian book in his memoir, Mapilai. That's what he's saying. Go to this website and read about it. You'll find shocking proof. So, geologists given us a proof. Early travelers have given us proof that Indians were Bantus, melanin dominant humans. Therefore, they are of African descent. When did the name India come into use, and who gave it prominence? Term India itself is a corruption of Sindhu or Sintu. Persians added S as H and called this land Hindu. Greeks pronounced this name as Indus. The name India is derived from the river Sindhu or Indus. Is this name a pointer to Africa? These are some of the names there. Consider this. One of the prominent names used for India in ancient times is Sindhu. This word is Sindhu, is of African origin. It means our culture. So there it is. There it is, one of the proofs that we are giving here. Now, Asia is also part of Africa. It's not a different continent. It's the same continent of Africa. Even the name Asia itself is an African name. So, whilst India is found in Asia, and Asia is the proper noun for that place and the whole region and the continent located there, the term, the etymology of this word from the Greeks Asia is Asiiwa. Just a twist here. Asiiwa. What does Asiiwa mean? It means they have left and they have been left there. So Asia is Asia, Africa. Straightforward. Can anthropology answer if India was a once an African nation? Aboriginal indigenous Indians, a significant portion of Indian DNA, almost half by some counts, is derived from the Aboriginal inhabitants of India, possibly descended from the human population that arrived there in the first waves of migration out of Africa 60,000 years ago. So there is no problem about that. So that's quite clear. He is the man that has given us a lot about the African presence in ancient continents. So read about him, find his books. This is Dr. Ronoko Rashid. In India today, there are tribes of the Andaman Islands with a physiological profile most similar to modern Australian Aborigines and the New Guineans are clearly the most representative proof of this ancient population, which has been labeled by geneticists as ancient ancestral South Indians. Aasi. They are simply Bantus. Don't waste your time telling us that they are Aasi or Feyaki or what. There they are. Straightforward characteristics of an ancient Indian society and culture. The Dravidians were black people, very peaceful people, dark-skinned Bantus. For those that say, oh, the pictures are modern, the camera was invented in 1828 and so forth, they caved. They left proof. So you are wasting your time and your argument is just invalid when you say, ah, the camera was invented recently, there were no pictures. There is the sculpture there of them. Now, let's look at history as also demonstrated by Dr. Ronoko Rashidi. India was an African country. We can see the people here. These are the original indigenous Bantus of India. The distinction between the black-skinned Sudroids races of southern India and fair-skinned Aryan races of northern India is not an invention of English colonialists or historians. It is a feature that is attested by Greek travelers who visited South Asia centuries before Robert Clive or any other European modern European historian. The ancient Greeks consider the Africans and Sudras, modern Dalits and Dravidians, as belonging to the same Ethiopian stock. Ethiopian was the Greek word for Negro, and the Greek authors referred to the African Negroes as Western Ethiopians and to the Sudroids as Eastern Ethiopians or Eastern Negroes. Herodotus 6:70. Witness the following citation from Herodotus. The Eastern Ethiopians, i.e. Sudras, differed in nothing from the other Ethiopians save their language and the character of their hair. For the Eastern Ethiopians have straight hair, while they of Libya, which is Africa, are more woolly haired than any other people in the world. We're giving the website where you can go and follow the link. Exceptional valuable writings reflecting close relationships between Africa and early India have existed for more than 2,000 years. In the first century before Common Era, for example, the famous historian Diodorus Siculus penned that from Ethiopia, he, Ausarije, passed through Arabia, bordering upon the Red Sea, as far as India. He built many cities in India, one of which he called Nyasa. There's Nyasa in Malawi, Nyasa in Hemet, and Nyasa in India, where he was born, was called Nyasa, where Ausarije was born. Quite clear, straightforward proof. Another important writer from antiquity, Apollonius Tyana, who is said to have visited India near the end of the first century common era, was convinced that the Ethiopians are colonists sent from India who followed their forefathers in matters of wisdom. The literary work of the early Christian writer Eusebius preserves the tradition that in the reign of Amenophis III, the mighty dynasty of the ancient Kemet, a body of Ethiopians migrated from the country about the Indus and settled in the valley of the Nile. And still another document from ancient times, the Aetrarium Alexandri, says that India, taken as a whole, beginning from the north and embracing what of its subjects to Persia, is a continuation of Egypt and the Ethiopians. There it is. So these who are coming back, they were our brothers who are coming. This is the other wave that then scholars are now using and saying the Euro-Asians, which is wrong. Or Asians are the ones that came into Africa. That is wrong. These people were coming back. There was no need for passport. The only passport that you had at that time is your melanin-dominant skin. If you had any other skin, you would be in trouble. It is safe to say that when we speak of the Dravidians as a people, we are speaking of the living descendants of the Harappan people of the ancient Indus Valley, who were pushed into South India as the result of the Aryan invasion, which many scholars are trying to deny, but there is Aryan invasion theory and a proof about it. And there is more proof about it. This is certainly consistent with the Dravidian tradition, which recall flourishing cities that were either destroyed or lost during antiquity. And the term Dravidian, however, encompasses both the ethnic people as well as their language. And characterized by straight wavy hair textures combined with Afrikaid physical features. This is what many other scholars have explained. There they are, the people that we are talking about. If ever you say these people are different, then honestly, you do not know what you are saying. If you study anthropology, you do your research, your DNA research, encounter this Dravidian type, and then conclude that the Negro type is absent, your scholarship is useless and does not work anymore. There is Dravidian people of South India. These are Bantus. Clearly straightforward, these are the people that are indigenous and autochthonous in India. They speak a language, over 100 million of them, which is Dravidian, and they are Bantus with the totems and African culture, which they were taught by Ausarije, our ancestors. So India was once an African nation through and through, no questions asked. Now, in conclusion, therefore, all autochthonous and indigenous people, so-called Negroes, Pan-Negroes, Melanesian Negroids, Indo-Negroids, Negro-Australoids, and Blacks are Bantus. Melanin-dominant humans, it's a time that we begin believing this without the limitations of the borders, without the limitations of the difference that have been planted in us. We are in amnesia about this, but it's time to unite without a delay. Find your glow again. Join the winners at joinatmarifado.com website. Visit our website, www.marifado.com. This preacher, Rabbi L.M. Dumizulu of Kamiti Hebrew Ethics, saying, Edupe enko siyabonga tatenda, till we meet again, we are one people.